Namaskar friends, at the outset I wish to thank the team NPTEL for giving us an opportunity to run this course, that is the Manufacturing Guidelines for Product Design. As the name suggests, there are two broad categories or two broad elements in this course. The first one are the Manufacturing Guidelines and the second one is the Product Design. And all of us have already understood, have already discussed, have already undergone courses related to both of these elements. We have understood the manufacturing processes in most of our courses. We have also discussed the product design process in some other courses. In fact, we have also run a MOOCs course on product design and development. So some of you may be wondering that what is the difference between that course and this particular course. That course was a 10-hour course, this is a 20-hour course, which means this will be discussed over a period of 8 weeks. Now, the difference basically is that we are trying to integrate the two elements together. The manufacturing guidelines we are trying to integrate with the product design process. So basically, we study product design from the soft engineering point of view. We learn about the product design process, we learn about the design for manufacturing, design for assembly, design for manufacturing and assembly, robust design, quality function deployment. So we learn product design, but we do not give adequate attention to how the design is going to be manufactured, how it is going to be actually made in the form of a product. So here we will try to see that how the manufacturing process knowledge must be augmented. We always study manufacturing from the point of view of the mechanism or the procedure of doing the process. How a wood will be converted into a chair is taught. The process is taught, but not the guidelines that what parameters we must keep in mind while shaping the wood, or what are the shapes of the wood that are possible when we are doing the turning or the cutting operation for the wood. So there are those type of guidelines, not only for woodworking but for machining, for casting, for compression molding, for injection molding, for blow molding, for most of the processes. We will try to see that what are the major guidelines, what are the manufacturing guidelines that a manufacturing engineer must learn, must revise when he is going to help a product designer in realizing his or her idea. So basically, I believe that the course is relevant to all engineers who are involved in the process of product design, because in this they will be able to use the knowledge of manufacturing while they are designing the product, so that the overall cycle time from conceptualization to launch of the product in the market can be minimized substantially. So invite all of you to join the course, and I really believe that this knowledge will certainly add another skill set in your already existing knowledge base. Thank you.